won't be back no more. Going back down south, child, don't you wanna go? Woman, I'm trouble, I be all good night. Well, babe, I just can't be satisfied, and I just can't keep on. Well, I feel like snapping pistol in your face. I'm gonna let some graveyard lord be her resting place. Woman, I'm trouble.
Hello, my name's Jack Humpty, and I've got multiple personality disorder. And that's, well, that's John Dumpty. Bickly shit, I know, but I guess he thought it was funny. John first made an appearance when he generously exposed our genitals to the whole school during an assembly in year four. From then on, he's been with me 24/7. He's been causing a bit of a ruckus. Though we do have a laugh now and again, like the time we stayed up all night drinking hot Ribena and watching Tracy Beaker, but that was 10 years ago. And if I'm being honest, I've had enough. I mean, don't get me wrong, I can enjoy a good laugh as much as the next bloke, but there's a fine line between being a joker and being an absolute mug. He's had numerous scrapes with the authorities and just generally been a bit of a wanker. So, when he was out gallivanting, I'd be trailing behind, picking up the pieces and getting fingered by the coppers. I'd go out after work for a nice pint with the lads from Woolworths and he'd end up emptying my wallet and getting warm sick all over the porcelain bowl. Look at me, I'm revolting. On many occasions, he'd end up pummeling some poor sod's face into the gravel.
If you didn't love me, why didn't you let me know? Darling, you've left me in tears. And I don't know what to do. I should have known from the start that you're not meant for me, that you would break my heart and leave me here in misery. Ever since you left the night, my heart is aching for you. There's nothing I do that can be right, 'cause I'm worried over you. If you didn't need my care, why didn't you let me know? Darling, I just can't resist.
After a while, I tried reasoning with him. You know, polite at first, but after he'd wolfed down 3 bacon butties and 2 jumbo bangers, I tried a different approach. Now, it's a strange thing having a conversation with yourself. You have a vague idea of what you're about to say, but when you actually do say it, you still find yourself surprised at what you've just heard. Like when you sing along to a song on the radio that you don't actually remember ever hearing before. For him, he was loving it. He knew exactly when I was bullshitting, like when I said, "I still want you around, buddy. It's not you, it's me. I'm just not ready for this kind of commitment. We can still be friends." Of course, he was having none of it, and knew full well that all I wanted to do was shove that jumbo sausage right up his tender little a-hole. He also knew that I couldn't, because it would hurt me just as much as him. And it was with this knowledge that he managed to so effortlessly make my life a constant shitstorm. And just as I thought I was starting to get through to him, he walked away from the situation, and nothing was resolved. I had to try out something new. I took copious amounts of medication, Melaril, Atropine, and Chlorpromazine. And none of them worked. Now, I know what some of you are thinking, you know. Bit of a drama queen, bit of a diva jumping off walls left, right and centre. And to be honest, you're right. but desperate times call for desperate measures. What I did, it was stupid, but it was only meant to scare him, shake him up a bit. I read somewhere that sometimes sudden trauma can alleviate people from their psychotic disorders. Of course, there's much more chance of being severely injured than of anything else, but that was a risk I was willing to take.